Okay, coming to the advantages and disadvantages of canal. First point under canal can irrigate a large area. Okay, so this the canals they can irrigate a very large area. Second point, perennial canals, as the name tells you, perennial. They are a perennial source of irrigation. That means they give water to the fields throughout the year. Sometimes the canals they deposit silt, SILT, which makes the soil fertile. And the last advantage, they are effective in flat plain lands with perennial rivers. Now, the exact condition that we find, the requirement that we find in the northern plains, which makes it so very common in the northern part of India. Under disadvantage, expensive will be one of the most important point. No farmers can make or construct canals on their own. They have to get the help from the government because it needs a lot of money. Inundation canals, they dry up in dry season. As done earlier, one of the type of canal is inundation, so they dry up in the dry season. If there's no rain, there'll be no water. Next point, overuse creates water logging. Water logging means the water stagnates, stands on the soil, making crop growing difficult. And the last point makes the soil infertile. How? By increasing the alkaline salt on the soil, or rather on the surface. From the soil, the alkaline salts come up on the surface if the canals are used more. Next, we come to tanks. Now, tanks mean reservoirs. Simple storage areas which can store the rain water. Area wise, you will find over here Peninsular India. Another word for Peninsular India you can remember is Deccan India, South India. Amongst the states, Karnataka, Maharashtra, Kerala, very important. Why do we have mainly tanks in the Peninsular India? More tanks apart from any other different types of irrigation methods. For the simple reason, Peninsular India's first point, rocky underlying layer does not allow water to seep, SEEP. Seep means the water does not go down. The rock layer stops the water from going deep down. Next point, uneven topography, that is the land is very uneven and the depressions in the land allows water to collect. Rainwater collects naturally in these uneven depression or uneven topography. Coming to the advantages, stores the rainwater which otherwise would have been wasted. Simple method. If the rainwater does not get stored, it will run away as runoff, surface runoff. So the tank stores the rainwater. It is economical, profitable. Helps to raise the underground water table simply by storing the water. And effective in areas with rocky terrain and seasonal stream. Seasonal stream, always that extra water they would have been wasted, which gets stored up in the tanks. Under disadvantages, tanks uses up large area which could have been used for farming. A big tank is there. Instead of that, what is the tank doing? It is wasting the agricultural land. In place of that tank, you could have, or the farmers could have practiced agriculture. Regular cleaning is required or needed. Otherwise, the tank will start silting. The water will become impure. Tanks also dry up in summer. And the last point, water is lost due to evaporation as tanks are shallow. Tanks are not very, very deep. They are shallow and the water gets evaporated very fast. So these are your advantages and disadvantages. Assignments, give reasons are there. Three questions. Please copy that down either in sheets of paper or in your exercise books, geography. Why canals are common in northern plains? We had discussed earlier in this clipping, so be a little attentive. Get back to the video clipping again, you will understand. Second, give reason why tube wells are better means of irrigation than wells. And third, tanks are common in the Deccan region. Why? Okay, so these are the three give reasons which you need to write down the answers, give the reasons for. And any comments or queries, please put it in the comment section of the YouTube.